don't want to know the name Bea Dyes. Is it from the Beatles, B-E-A, or am I just like...
Well, after that, I mean, I did sit down and try really hard to get, you know what I mean? But, yeah, it works out that way. B-E-A is just, you know, keeping an eye on things, you know what I mean? But it doesn't really mean anything. But it looks good on paper.
As soon as Liam came up with BDI and he texted me and I just went, that's the one. In fact, he didn't even get full stop. It was just, I knew it, you know.
Is it a conscious decision to move it musically away from Oasis?
Not really, no. I don't think we have, really. I mean, we're still influenced by the same people that were influenced when we started Oasis and that. We're not certainly got, you know, we've not got a new passion for Earth, Wind and Fire or anything, you know what I mean?
Well, what's really changed is that maybe the working methods have changed a little bit, the way we get the songs down, but the drive is still coming from the same place.
I mean, for me, when I heard it, it did sound like the sound had moved on into a different place. It was looser. And you're singing in a different kind of way as well, aren't you?
Yeah, maybe, yeah. I like my vocals on this album. I think it's pretty good. But it's down to, like, confidence, you know what I mean? If you're singing and you're doing 20-odd takes, you know what I mean, and people have, you know... You know, you're in a room all day and you're on side by candles, you know what I mean?
Yeah, love that. So who's writing the words then? You write the words?
I write the words for my songs, yeah, again, right.
Yeah, we kind of all do our own initial thing. We come in with the skeleton.
So the album title, is that kind of saying what your situation is now?
Different gear, man, it sort of says itself, done it, different gear, still speeding, we still got it, we still want it, you know what I mean?
Yes, yeah, so it's definitely like drawing a line.
Yeah, and we're not taking our foot off the gas either. We're gonna whip him hard, man.
Yeah, I like the way you just, it's pretty punk rock, you just carried on.
Yeah.
Yeah. You didn't know what to say. The alchemist you today. Can't get out your own way. Well, hold on. It's a dynamic in the band difference, obviously, without...
Yeah, well, obviously, Noel was, like, the main guy who wrote the songs, and he'd sort of have his outlook on how the album would sound and going, and we'd sort of just do our thing, and that. And my thing would be at the end. I'd sort of sing towards the end when all the music was done. Now, the vocals are down pretty quick, you know what I mean, so...
Is it easier doing this now without having Noel hit?
I don't know, man, I don't know. It's just great being in a band, you know what I mean, that's... Regardless, you know, with Noel and that, it's just great to be back with a new, you know, with a new record, you know what I mean? That's what we're here to do, is to be, you know, to be in a band talking about it and playing it and can't wait to go out and play the gigs, you know what I mean? And whatever else happens, that will happen.
But is it a better atmosphere?
Yeah, man, I mean, we had a good time in Oasis, you know? It wasn't like, you know, it wasn't gloomy and that, we had a good time, but it feels good, man. It feels good to be back making records, you know what I mean? And not sitting about talking about it and, you know, waiting... You know, going, we're going to do a record in 5 years. This is, we're not getting any old, you know, we're not getting any younger, you know what I mean? We've got music, let's get out there and play it. That's what it's about.
Yeah, because you come out really quickly, this one. Yeah. I mean, what is it? It's only about a year since Oasis stopped.
A year, but we split up in August and we were demoing the following couple of weeks, you know what I mean? We said, oh, we'll meet up in a couple of months and go through a couple of tunes that we had. We couldn't wait that long, so got a little studio booked, went down there, had a couple of tunes, got them sounding good, sent them to Chris. Chris drummed on it, and it... We just sorted it out, man. It felt good. Just come in the road. I squeeze and unfold, yeah. Come in the road. I just go to show, yeah. It was a heavy night. Really heavy.
As I've said before, it was the best 10 years of my life to that point. But then, you know, we all just looked around the room in Paris. And look at each other, and it was like we just felt we weren't ready for stopping.
Yeah.
You know, there was definitely an electricity in the air between the eyes, and then we had, like Liam said, we had a plan to start in November after the August, you know, get unpacked. And
but we haven't stopped really since then, you know what I mean? And we're waiting to do the album in the summer and that, so we haven't stopped like now, which is great, you know what I mean? But there's no way I'm going out like that after a Paris gig like that, you know what I mean? It felt wrong, you know what I mean, to just sort of fell apart, you know what I mean? So
I don't think we can. We like can't that. Stop, can
yeah,
we?
You know, we all felt like that, so we thought, you know, we owe it to ourselves and to the people who are into what we do, you know what I mean?
In fact,
I mean,
yeah.
Was there any songs that were there for Oasis that carried on into this record? Was this all completely clean slate?
There was a few. I hate to say that they were lying about. They were sort of just leaning against the wall, waiting to be put on the dance floor, you know what I mean?
Yeah, just they're just scraps and not finished yet.
Yeah, man. I mean, some of them were demoed before, but we hadn't, all of us, we'd not made a record with Chris, you know what I mean? So that was another thing we wanted to do.
I mean, who calls the shots now, is it?
No one.
All of us.
Is it democratic, yeah.
Yeah, man, that's the way it should be, you know what I mean? If you want to be in a band, you've got to give a little, haven't you, you know what I mean? Otherwise, you know, if it goes wrong, then it's all on your head, and that's no way to live, is it?
Yeah, and democratic, I would say it shouldn't work, but it's more of a collective, it's collective consciousness, collective thought, or rather, we're all just bang up for it.
It's sort of a unique situation. Like, normally I'd say a democratic band wouldn't really work. I've been in those kind of bands before, and they kind of ended up a bit...
You have to vote 3-1, 2-2.
Yeah, it kind of... Yeah. But for us...
Yeah, it's not a coalition, man.
This is what works.
Not
this
a band
is what
for Nick Clegg's and David Cameron, man.
Yeah.
Thank God for that.
Yeah.
But what happens if you came up with a song and everyone else hated it, do you say...?
Then I would bin it straight away.
Yes, it's...
Because, you know, I don't know it all. Completely. But that's like everything, man. The T-shirts or whatever you want to... By the time we're all pointing at it, it's happening. And if everybody's sort of going, then it's fucking out, man.
You can tell pretty much instantly, you know what I mean, if you're digging it, because everyone sort of leaves the chair, you know what I mean, and does a little dance or a little shuffle, you know what I mean, and you go, ah, we're onto something. It's like Gem says, you know what I mean, if it takes 20 minutes to mull over it, then it's not right, you know what I mean. It's instant, then we move on, we say, we agree, and then we move on.
Did you feel actually under pressure yourself, Lee?
Don't feel no pressure.
No, that's what I thought you'd say.
No, but yeah. I mean it, man. Being in a band, it should be a great thing, you know what I mean? If it's pressure, then... You know what I mean? I think people who work in McDonald's must feel under pressure. So you've been crawling through a maze.
And is the best bit creating the songs or singing them?
Singing them. The creating the song is something of a nightmare, isn't it? Drives you mad, but...
That's the bit I like.
Yeah.
So, Jem, if you wrote a song and no one else liked it, would you care if it was, like, thrown away?
We would bin it straight away.
And so there's no tension about that at all, then?
No.
He has written songs that we've binned.
I mean, we've all got to be feeling it, haven't we, for it to work, you know what I mean?
What is one of your songs, Liam?
Without a doubt, I'm the first person to bin my tunes, you know what I mean?
I don't think you'd play it to us if it was, wasn't any good anyway, would you? You don't get written.
But so would that be different from Oasis if Noel had a song and everyone else didn't like it? Would he kind of push that through?
But if Noel sort of wrote a tune, done his thing, that'd be the end of it. You'd have to do it, I suppose. You know what I mean? But it wasn't, you know what I mean, cracking the whip. But
I mean, when you say vision,
it's not that bad.
Yeah,
it's not all bad.
When you say vision, do you have a vision for this, or is it just seeing how it creates itself?
Making great music, man. Great melodies, and you know, be able to play it live. That's the vision, really. You know what I mean? Want to go around the world, want to be the biggest band in the world again, without a doubt, that's the name of the game, isn't it?
Do you still have that motivation? Without a doubt,
what will inspire people, whether it's in England or it's over in South America, wherever. If the biggest band that we were ever in is Oasis, then so be it, you know what I mean? It won't be through the lack of trying, you know what I mean? Or the passion, you know what I mean? We're into this as much as we're into Oasis, you know what I mean? The vibe's still there, you know what I mean? You still want to make a great record like we did with Oasis the first time round. But you're a little bit older and you're a little bit wiser and you know a little bit more, you know what I mean?
I mean, do you think you've changed quite a bit as a person?
Yeah, a little bit.
But on tour, do you keep it fairly down? I mean, the madness is there, but do you still keep it... You still go to Waitrose on the tour as well, kind of thing, you know?
On the tour?
Yeah, do you have, like, one foot in both worlds?
I've got a Waitrose on tour, man.
Yeah, so you go back to Rockstar.
Keep employment down, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I do my own thing, man. I'm not a diva, man.
Do you think you'll be able to get through a whole American tour this time?
Without a doubt, I mean, yeah, why not? I mean, I did well last time, man. I don't think I cancelled any gigs, but the gigs that were ever cancelled were because it all mainly through the throat, you know what I mean? It was never because anyone had a strop. I'm not that way. So you've got to look after yourself, do a bit. You know, look after myself a bit more.
Are you much more in control of this situation now, BDI?
Yeah, I'd like to think so. I mean, we're all in it, man. We're all in it for the right reasons. We all want it to be a success. You know, without a doubt.
Yeah, but it's...
We don't want to ram it down people's throats. It's there for the take. If you want it, you like it, go and buy the record, sell it up. If you don't, move on.
Is a lot of the early madness and aggression is still there, isn't it?
Still there, without a doubt. The day that goes, then God help us all. You know what I mean? You need a bit of that. But that's just there regardless, you know. You don't give it a call, you know what I mean? It's in me, you know what I mean?
But do you try and keep control of that a bit more?
In what way?
You know, like, because you used to be fly off the handle.
As soon as that microphone's in front of me, that's it. That's
There's actually some quite touching can I say, even sensitive quiet songs.
Yeah, without a doubt, yeah, I'm made up of all sorts, me, you know what I mean? I'm not just a angry little lunatic, you know what I mean? I've got feelings, that's what it's about.
Yeah, I mean, and do you find it hard as a Northern, like a Northern as well? Mm. It's hard to be sensitive, isn't it? It's a bit...
Not for me. I get that probably from my mum, and I brought up 90%, you know what I mean, my life by a woman, so that's there, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, maybe that's the beauty of rock and roll, that you can actually give you a space where you don't have to be a hard man all the time, innit?
Yeah, man. Just whenever it's necessary.
I mean, when Oasis stopped and Kasabian sort of came through, I mean, would you think they took the crown?
No. No, you'd have to mug me for that. You know what I mean? Without a doubt, no one's took anything. I'd have to sit down and go, right, we're going to make an album that sounds like the Beatles. It just happens, you know what I mean? That's
like when you have a shower in the morning, the Beatles comes out of the shower.
Which would be pretty
and,
cool.
And you make your tea with Beatle water. You don't sort of decide to be Beatles, you just are Beatles.
But do you, yeah, so you're the last standard bearer.
The thing is, when people go on about, like, this sound like the Beatles, I just think we sound like a British rock and roll band, you know what I mean? And if that's like the Beatles, then so be it, you know what I mean? We don't wake up in the morning and go, right, let's kind of sound like John Lennon or whatever. It's just, that's the way it is, I think we just sound English, you know what I mean?
Well, but wasn't it McCartney who said, because somebody said to him that Oasis, your old band, sounded like the Beatles, and he said, but the Beatles sound like everybody else anyway.
There you go.
I never really did in Oasis records that much. I heard the Sex Pistols and you know, Slade and stuff, and a bit of maybe a Lennon solo thing going on, but I think BDI has got more in common with the Beatles sound than Oasis did.
When you go out on tour, is it going to be like the old days in Oasis, or is it a bit more...
Well, I don't know, it depends what the old days in Oasis were like. What were they like?
I think in the early days it was a bit rock and roll, wasn't it? There's a lot of great stories.
Yeah, man, no, I don't think it'd be like that. Yeah, man, we'll be doing what we've got to do on stage, getting that done, and then having a laugh, you know what I mean?
I mean, we still want to get about, you know, there's no countries that are off the list. It just means if we're going to South America or wherever, we'll be playing clubs and theatres, you know? But so that in itself will be a trip.
So was there pressure from people saying, ooh, you have to play an Oasis song as well?
No pressure, man. I think that would be weird, man. That's like, you might as well, you'd end up in the nut house, man. It'd be like, you know, like with, you know, a pet or something, you know what I mean? Not putting it down when it, you know, when it's in the agony. You've got to do the right thing and just let it go, you know what I mean?
How's it, you know, when you're doing this live, obviously in rehearsal because you've not played a gig yet, does it feel weird without having Noel there?
No. Don't feel, honest, man, it don't feel weird. I reckon it'll feel weird for him, not having me not there. That'll be weird, I reckon.
Yeah, I reckon it will, yeah. But does it not feel...
Don't feel weird, no.
Yeah. I mean, see, do you actually miss them at all?
Do I actually miss Noel?
Yeah.
Not yet, no.
Yeah. Have you not spoken to each other since
then?
Not
spoken to him. But that'll happen, hopefully it will happen. It'll be sad if we don't, but we will. But at the moment, we're still, you know, I'm busy doing this, and he's probably busy doing his thing, but, you know, it'll happen when it happens.
And is there no chance you're going to speak to Noel at some point?
I don't know, man. I mean, listen, we had an argument. We always had arguments, that's the way it was. I don't think it was about an argument. I think our kid wanted out. So I think he'd done his time with the band and that, and which is fair play, but all he had to do was go, look, I'm doing this thing, I think we've run our course. Fine, we had an argument, we always argued. And that was purely about him being a dick and me being a dick, and that's allowed. It was our band. So, yeah, it's disappointing that it ended, but we move on, you know what I mean?
I mean, was it a shock when it actually was finally properly over?
I kind of seen it coming, you know what I mean? Our kid had sort of distanced himself from us anyway. There's a lot of talk about me travelling separately and having different dressing rooms. That's just lies, you know what I mean? I was always a band player, you know what I mean? So I kind of seen it coming, you know what I mean? I think he just wanted out. You'd have to ask him when he comes around to take over the world when it's his turn. But by the time, you know, and he's playing the quiet card, but... By the time he gets out of doing his thing, I'm sure he's going to get asked about it, and we'll be rocking on a stage.
You want his record to be good, though?
For music, without a doubt, of course. I love him, you know what I mean? He's my brother, I don't want him to write shit.
Yeah, it's difficult.
And he'll know about it if he writes shit. He'll know about it for me, you know what I mean?
Yeah. It's not like Lennon McCartney, is it? You actually...
Yeah, my brother's, and it upsets me, mum, and that, but, you know...
She tried to say, ring him up.
She sort of comes like, oh, no, I was asking you for the other day. I'm like, yeah, because I'm... It'll happen when it happens, you know what I mean? It'll happen, but, you know...
He makes
it's only a year and a half ago, so I'm not missing him that ready, not that soon, so I don't think he's missing me, so...
It's who's got to make the first call that's difficult.
Well, I'm that kind of person. I'll probably make the first call.
Yeah.
I'll probably get the phone put down, but I'm a bigger man, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
But
it's a tough lot.
It's nowhere near in the future just yet.
Because he's written a bunch of songs now, hasn't he?
Apparently so, yeah.
McGee said they were really good.
Yeah, what would McGee know?
Well, have you fallen out with him?
Not fallen out with him, no. Fallen out with anyone, no.
Yeah.
I'm sure Noel's songs are really good.
Yeah,
I'm sure he's going to make a great album, undoubtedly.
And I'd like for people to, you know, we'll get Noel's album, we'll get our album, they stick him on their iPods and they'll have a great holiday or whatever they do with their lives, you know, that's surely it.
Yeah.
You know, and as we say, nobody's died and everything has a natural arc.
I think with Oasis, there wasn't really much further that could go, really. So I think in some ways...
It's kind of on tap for me, you know what I mean? Everyone knew that we were going to be doing a record and it'd be coming out that, and there's nothing worse than people dragging their feet to a concert, you know what I mean? And this time round, hopefully we won't... You know, we're not going to be on tap.
So is it good to have a feeling you have to prove something? You know, it's a new band, new songs.
But honestly, man, I don't feel like we have to prove anything, you know what I mean? It's just that we've got to connect, without a doubt. You know, you can write great songs, but if they don't connect to the people, then there's no point, really, is there? But, you know, hopefully we'll connect, you know what I mean? We can get on something special, make something special.